Hi, I'm Gary from Gary's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to make cards with lots of blue, and I'm going to use Nuvo Aquaflow pens. I start with spraying the card on both sides against warping, and I spray a bit more water at the top, and then I start to add the color. I want a bit of a purple blue, so I mix the colors a bit. When you want more color, you can squeeze the pen to let a bit more ink out on the part where it says press on the pen. Now the camera was totally out of focus when I did the original cards, so I'm making a new background here, which is done in exactly the same way as the ones I will show you in a bit. And then I spray some more water to let the color move. Just so you know, I added the main products I used in the description box for you. You can also find the full list of supplies on my blog. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. And when you do so, you may like to click the little notification bell, so you don't miss a thing. So here are the first two cards I made, and I will continue with these as these were the ones I turned into cards. I'm going to stamp with Distress Oxide ink, just some freehand stamping. And then I add embossing powder and I wipe away parts with my finger because I want a part of the ink to still show. And this will give a fun gloss and matte effect. And I do the same for the other card, but with the stamp sideways. I add the embossing powder and I'm going to melt this one too. And here I use a brush to remove bits of the embossing powder. And now I'm going to add a bit of texture also in the lighter part. Again some freehand stamping with adding more or less pressure in different spots. I'm going to stamp some mushrooms with clear embossing ink. And I add embossing powder and shake off the excess. And then I stamp the next mushroom and I do the same. You can heat set in between so you don't mess up the first one. If you work fast, the powder will hold. Then I heat set the powder, and I did the other card in the same way. Stamping some more mushrooms again with clear embossing ink. I add the embossing powder and then I melt it. I fussy cut the mushrooms, and I did the same for a bunch more. I'm going to color the top of the mushrooms with true turquoise, and I add the color on one side and then blend it out with a water brush. So here I have all parts together, and sometimes I lay out all the parts and then I still have to add tape. So if I remember, I take a picture so I can take off all parts and I can add them back in the same way. I have foam tape and regular tape on the back already, and I added the backgrounds to dark blue note cards. And I add one of the leftover mushrooms to the inside of the card. And then I add the rest. Now the sentiment, I add some water to the card and then I add some dark blue with the Acroflow pen. And I clean the water brush on a paper towel by brushing it back and forth. I'm going to stamp some words. I have cut the piece so I can stamp the words I want, and then I add them with tape because they are too small for the magnets. And then I place the stamp on top. A bit of glue with a funky glue stick so the stamp stays in place. And I'm going to stamp it a few times with clear mark embossing ink. I add a pretty embossing powder, and then I'm going to melt it with a heat tool. And it's not visible. So I change the plan and make it visible by adding more color. And I blend it out with a water brush, and then I'm going to blot it with kitchen towel. Fussy cut the sentiments, and then I sand the edges so I get a nice white edge, which will make the sentiments stand out more. I added foam tape to the back. And I pre-made some Nuvo drops and I used the same drops as a glue. So here are the finished cards. I hope you are inspired to get crafty with your favorite color. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And make sure to keep on crafting!